So I want to just read over the text on today, amen, and I think it's a beautiful text, amen, which says in the ninth chapter of Matthew, amen, the ninth chapter of Matthew, the 37th and 38th verses here, and we're just going to talk about that for a minute. I know it's been a long day and probably a long week for many of you also. It's my purpose not to be before you too long, but I pray that the God, yes, that God will speak something through me that will be a blessing and a help to all of us, amen. Praise the Lord. So we know what it says. It says, then saith he unto his disciples, the harvest truly is plenteous, but the laborers are few. Pray ye therefore the Lord of the harvest that he will send forth laborers into the harvest. Somebody say with me, it's all about souls. Amen. Come on, somebody. I realized a long time ago that there's some people, preacher, I ain't gonna never be able to help. There's some people I'm gonna never come in contact with. Amen. But with as many people as love God, if we would all take the responsibility of being a witness for God, amen. Come on, y'all. We take that responsibility and be the laborers that God called us to be. There are all these people that we see out here walking up and down the street. Some of us are neighbors, some of our loved ones. It's plenteous. It's plenty. You know, churches don't have no business being jealous and envious and all and mad at one another. But you know why? Because there's plenty of folks to go around. There's plenty of folks to help. There's plenty of folks that need God's guidance, that need God's help. But I tell you what, them children that got up here and testified, amen, about why they like this church. Come on now, even a child understands that they need God in their heart. That touched my heart. That blessed me, brother. Amen. That's a blessing to have even children to realize how great God is, how awesome God is, how needful God is in their life. I wish I'd have had that much sense when I was their age. Amen. Come on, y'all. Many of the suffering, many of the things, the trials and the tribulations that I went through needlessly, because if I only listened to my grandma, when my grandma would say, sometimes y'all go to church sometime.
Yeah.
I'd come in the middle of the night, sometime 2, 3, 4, 5 o'clock in the morning, zonked out of my head, been out smoking weed all night. All right. Can I preach? And drinking and doing all kind of stuff. And I'd come in and my grandma would be down on the knees, praying out, crying out, saying my name, my cousin's name, my brother's name, everybody's name. And she'd be crying out 3 hours in the morning. If I just had no sense, come on now, at that age, many of the things I went through, many of the things I suffered that I didn't have to suffer. But thank God there's a church on this corner. And the Bible, and it says with this greater faith. It says, greater faith, missionary Baptist church. And I got to thinking about Sister Jones got up here, I believe it was. And she was saying how she was breaking it down. But I got to thinking about that greater part. When something is greater, that means it's more than. That's almost like David when he said, my cup runneth over. It's if you are a greater faith. And God is with the more folks you got out here that's lost and messed up. You know what's some messed up folks out here? There's some messed up folks in the church. And you're going to need some greater faith. You need some greater faith. Come on now, you need some faith that's going to stretch out and cry out to God and know that God is going to move on your behalf. No matter what it look like, no matter what it seemed like, no matter what they said or didn't say, you got to know that you can put your faith in the faithfulness of God and step out on it and don't worry about it, don't stretch your head about it. Just know that God means what he said. He said his honors is running above his name, and his name is above everything. Don't try to figure it out, you'll blow your brains out. But his name is above every name, and the honors is running above that. Now you got to put faith in the faithfulness of God. Faith in God, not faith in me, not faith in your job, not faith in your husband, not faith in your wife. It's all right to trust them, but you put your faith in God, because I can fail you, and I ain't intending to, but I could fail you. But I want you to know that God said he'd never leave you or forsake you. He said he'd never leave you alone, and God can't lie. 24 years. Preacher, I'm a pastor. I know. I know it's been some hard times. I already know it's been some ups and downs. I know it's been some disappointments. I know there's been some folks that have been here and have left here. I know there's been some folks that have come and gone and have hurt you because you saying. There's a whole lot of folks that you need to be here when they come through the door. It's good to be where you need to be when you need to be there, because you don't know who's coming. It might be somebody coming who you got just what they need.
Yeah.
You know, somebody got, that person got just what you need, what you could come provide, and you need to be here.
Yeah.
Many of you sitting here, amen, and maybe you've been here from the beginning, maybe not, maybe you've been here a few years, maybe you've been here 2 years, three, four, five, whatever it is. If God sent you here, this is where you're supposed to be. Come on, somebody, this is where you're supposed to grow. This is where you're supposed to watch a blessing after somebody. Don't just have a testimony, be a testimony. When folks can come together and dwell together in unity, come on, y'all, that's a wonderful thing. That's a beautiful thing. When the people of God can come together, preacher, I'm glad to be here. I'm glad we ain't got to reinvent the wheel. The wheel has already been invented. All we need to get the saints of God, the people of God, we need to learn how to get together. And you saw me in one accord. He said, we had all things in one accord. Come on now. They all minded the same thing. You let all the people of God truly, truly get together and pray and seek Him. Come on, I've been praying for your church. Because I know you're praying for mine.
Yes, sir.
It ain't no competition thing. Hallelujah. Right. Pastor Drew and your church was praying when they were singing. I wanted to play along with them. I didn't mean no harm. I didn't want to mess them up or nothing. But I just got the Lord down on the inside. And I just wanted to participate in what we was doing. Come on now. What you're doing is a good thing. I want to, brother. Come on, brother. It's a good thing. Just to come together and work together and stop working against each other. Come on now, y'all. That's what the Lord can see. That is a reality. He's serving a true and living God. He wants his electric light shine in such a way that men might see. First, got to see something.
That's right. Yeah.
Preach.
They got to see something.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Greater. Greater. And Jesus told us, greater works than these.
Yeah.
We got televisions, we got radio, we got all kind of electronic. Look at this fella, he ain't got some kind of gadget, watch or something on. I don't know what it is, but it's like all kind of stuff. You can do greater works. You got everything to work with. This microphone, Jesus put on the side of a mountain.
Yeah.
He got to preach it, and the folks heard him. Yeah, I got a microphone to amplify my voice. But Jesus, come on, y'all. Yeah. Don't you know that the power, when the power of God is working, what needs to be heard will be heard. But you've got to make yourself available. You've got to be in a place and to cry out and tell somebody about the goodness of God. Don't you never be ashamed. Paul said like this, I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, but it is the power. Guess what, people? Power does something. Power disturbs stuff. Power tears stuff up. It ain't right. Come on now. If you preach, and you preach, then we power up.
Yeah.
Come on here.
Yeah.
You're supposed to be sitting up in church and messed up in your heart and in your spirit and be able to walk right out here. Come on, something's supposed to happen. The spirit of conviction is supposed to come upon you. And when it comes upon you and you get right, then you can tell somebody else about how good Christ is, about how God bless you, about how God took the hatred out of your heart, God took the envy and the backbiting out of your heart. And then you can tell somebody else, and God is no respecter of person. And if God did it for me, He can do it for you. That's all you got to do. But we at the church, I ain't talking about your particular church, but I'm talking about the universal church. If we all come to that understanding and that knowledge, then the devil can't do nothing to us. When we submit ourselves to God, then we'll be able to resist the devil, and the devil got to flee from us. I said it this morning, he won't walk away, he got to run away. Come on now, he got to flee. He got to head up and get out of your face. Because if we submit to God, God will bless us, and the power of God, and the light of God, and the strength of God will shine from us.
Come on. Yeah. All right, man. Yeah.
24 years. Hallelujah. I thought me and my wife had done something.